What's up, y'all? It's your boy Jay Calderon, Stand Clear Entertainment, and we're about to get into this week's boxing talk. It has been made official, ladies and gentlemen. Miguel Cotto will be taking on Canelo Alvarez for the WBC Lineal Middleweight Championship at a catchweight of 155 pounds in Las Vegas, Nevada at the Mandalay Bay, November 21st, 2015. By Roc Nation and Golden Boy Promotions have put this fight together, and it has been over a year that this fight has been building up, and the fans are finally having this fight sign, seal, and deliver. And they cannot wait for the biggest fight of 2015 behind Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather, of course. But that fight did not live up to the expectations and the hype that was behind it. So this fight right here is definitely going to be probably the biggest fight of the year of 2015. It is an all-action fight. This is a fight between two men that are tough, and they are heavily populated in their countries of Puerto Rico and Mexico. This is the rivalry that has been going on for many, many years in boxing. The biggest rivalry between Mexico and Puerto Rico. Canelo Alvarez is a young, hungry, strong, intelligent, and very powerful punching junior middleweight in the division. And this guy is ready to bring it. He's ready to show his fans that he is the next superstar in boxing. But Miguel Cotto, this guy is a seasoned veteran, a world champion that has won 5 world titles in 4 weight divisions. The first Puerto Rican ever to win titles in 4 weight classes, from junior welterweight to welterweight to junior middleweight, and now the current middleweight king of the division. This fight, man, I mean, I'm telling you, this fight is going to be blood, guts. It's going to be an all-out warfare. There's going to be some knockdowns. You got to believe it, man. These guys are two hard-hitting punches. And I just want to do a little history on the Puerto Rico versus Mexico rivalry. I mean, there's no bigger fight ever in the history between these two countries, between Puerto Rico and also Mexico, like Salvador Sanchez versus Wilfredo Gomez. That was the absolute biggest fight that you could say in the history between these two, Puerto Rico and Mexico. And we all know that this is the greatest victory in Mexico history, when Salvador Sanchez stopped Wilfredo Gomez in the 8th round of that fight. It is a classic war when these guys were in their prime and at the top of their game, and the two biggest stars fighting at the time. And it was a featherweight fight at 126 pounds. It came down in the 1970s, and it was a beautiful, beautiful warfare that ended for Puerto Rico, and Mexico raised their flag. Now, years later, we had the great Julio Cesar Chavez, probably the greatest Mexican fighter of all time, take on the flamboyant Hector Macho Camacho and beat him down for a one-sided decision. And also, he faced the hard-hitting puncher from Puerto Rico, which was Errol Rosario. Now, that fight was an outstanding fight. It was a tough battle, a brutal battle that ended with an 11th-round KO for Mexico, as Chavez just chopped down Rosario to a bloody mess in that 11th-round stoppage. Also, you had in the 1990s, it was the biggest fight between two young, undefeated world champions at the welterweight division. It was Felix Tito Trinidad versus the Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya, for perhaps the biggest pay-per-view for a non-heavyweight bout. It was Mexico versus Puerto Rico that night, and it was such a big fight. Such a huge fight. And I remember that fight quite clearly. Now, even though Puerto Rico got the victory when Trinidad's hand was raised, we all know the real truth. We know that Oscar De La Hoya gave Trinidad a boxing lesson. But in the same sense, he also threw the fight away. He ran for the last 3 or 4 rounds in that fight on the advice of his corner, which was bad advice for him, and he threw away the fight. It allowed Trinidad to get back into the fight and get the decision victory. And Puerto Rico had perhaps its biggest victory, but not its most satisfying victory. Not at all. Not by a long shot. But then years later, it became my personal favorite. It was Felix Trinidad versus Fernando Vargas. Now, this was a great Mexico versus Puerto Rico rivalry. It was a young, hungry, strong lion that was a world champion in Fernando Vargas. He was hot on the scene and an up-and-coming champion against a seasoned veteran like Tito Trinidad. And that fight from beginning, from the opening bell to the final round with the spectacular knockout of Trinidad knocking out Vargas in that 12th and final round. I mean, that was a dog fight. That was a brutal fight. There was knockdowns about, I say there was about 5 or 6 knockdowns in that fight, I believe. And it was a beautiful, great victory for Puerto Rico when Trinidad was able to finish off Vargas. And I will always, always love that fight as one of my number one fights ever from between these rivalries. It was at 154 pounds for the junior middleweight title. Now, this fight right here between Mexico and Puerto Rico, we know that Cotto has had this scene before, and it was with Antonio Margarito. And I was at that fight in Las Vegas, and there was a very big Mexican crowd. People don't realize that Mexico and also Texas and California are very close to Las Vegas. It's more easier travel for those people to come over from California, Texas, and Mexico than from people coming over from Puerto Rico, the island, and also from New York City, Philadelphia, and Florida. All those Puerto Rican fans coming across from the East Coast to the West Coast and everything. So there's going to be a strong Mexican crowd on hand for Canelo Alvarez. I wish this fight was in New York so that Cotto could have the advantage with the crowd, but this is going to be a serious battle. You know, that first fight between Antonio Margarito and against Cotto was tainted because there's heavy speculation that Miguel Cotto was cheated by Antonio Margarito because they say that his hands was wrapped. There's no proof of that, but we know that Miguel's face was mangled. After he gave a beautiful boxing lesson to Antonio Margarito, he started to feel the pressure and was chopped down to the body. And also his face was mangled by the 11th round as he quit because the punishment was just too much. And it could have been because of those hand wraps. But Cotto had his revenge years later at Madison Square Garden when he stopped Antonio Margarito, who already had a bad injured eye, and Miguel Cotto just basically closed that eye and got his satisfaction of victory. But that Puerto Rican-Mexican rivalry is not what we're looking for. We're looking for that Tito Trinidad-Vargas victory for Puerto Rico. We're looking for Miguel Cotto to go to Las Vegas and finally have his big, big moment. You know, he went to Vegas several times before for big fights against Floyd Mayweather, against Manny Pacquiao, and against Margarito, and he's came up short. So we hope that this time he goes to Las Vegas and he comes out victorious in this fight. I'm Team Cotto all the way, but I'm not going to deny. This is a 50-50 fight. Canelo Alvarez is a live fighter. This guy is a young, strong, bigger fighter than Miguel Cotto. He comes in the ring about 170 to 175 pounds. He's a strong young fighter that has very good punching power. Now, let's not get it twisted. Everybody is all happy because the way he destroyed James Kirkland. James Kirkland had not fought in over a year and a half, almost 2 years old, ring rust, and had to get down in weight. And this guy was also knocked out by this Japanese dude in the first round. So I won't give a lot of credit to Canelo. It was a great knockout. Yes, indeed. And Canelo is an absolute great fighter, a young fighter. And they're depending on him to be the future star. Cotto is on his way out, but he's still a live underdog. This guy has the experience. This guy has the technical boxing skills to move around that ring and not go toe-to-toe with the hungry young lion. He's going to have to be smarter. He's going to have to use his experience. He's going to have to use that very good jab that he has never lost. The same jab that gave Floyd Mayweather a bloody nose. The same jab that he used against Antonio Margarito and against Shane Mosley when he knocked his head back with that powerful jab. The same jab that put Joshua Clady down in their fight. I mean, Cotto has a very good jab, better than Canelo Alvarez. Both guys are powerful punchers to the body, excellent body punchers. But I say that Miguel Cotto's left hook is the best weapon in this fight for Canelo Alvarez. He has a better left hook and a more powerful punch with that devastating hook that is going to really test Canelo Alvarez's chin. Canelo Alvarez has faced only two real punches in his career, and that is Fredo Angulo and James Kirkland. Those guys were sitting ducks. They had no movement, and they were right there for Canelo to pick them apart easily. Cotto's a different fighter. This guy uses his legs. He showed great defense against Sergio Martinez. Martinez had bum legs. Yes, this was an older fighter. Cotto was the underdog in that fight. But one thing that I took away from that fight, because I was there personally and I was watching that fight, was the defense, the movement that I saw from Miguel Cotto. That impressed me more than the knockdowns, more than anything else. That right there showed me that Freddie Roach has done an excellent job with Miguel Cotto, that it has improved him somewhat and also brought back some of the old Miguel Cotto. Now, like I said, both of these guys are real hard-hitting punchers. Cotto has been hit to the chin. He has been down, but he has gotten up and he has fought back. Canelo has never been in that situation. To me, Canelo is easy to outbox. Floyd Mayweather showed that. Also, I believe that Austin Trout and Lara both beat Canelo in a close fight, but the decision was given to Canelo. Those guys were able to move on Canelo. They didn't show enough firepower and they didn't have enough punching power to really do damage to Canelo. Now, Cotto does have that power. He also has that movement to offset Canelo. Canelo's job is to get inside and to force Cotto into the corner or on the ropes where he could do damage to the body and also hurt him. We're going to see how this fight plays out, and I can't wait for this fight to happen. So tune in to HBO November 21st, Miguel Cotto versus Canelo Alvarez, Puerto Rico versus Mexico. I would like to thank everybody for watching and continue to keep on following me on Instagram and also join my Facebook group boxing page. And also, please, please subscribe to the YouTube channel, Jay Calderon Boxing Talk. I'm Jay Calderon, Stand Clear Entertainment. Thanks for watching.